listening to Winnipeg's Classic 107. My name is Simon Rusnak. Since 1976, the Manitoba Band Association has actively encouraged young musicians through festival performances, providing an opportunity to hear their peers and work alongside respected clinicians. This year, the Concert Band Festival takes place February 20th through 23rd at the RBC Convention Center, with the Jazz Band Festival at the end of the month, part of the MBA family of festivals. Over the next few weeks, you can look forward to some in-studio performances by student groups, starting this morning with a jazz combo from Sturgeon Heights Collegiate, directed by Kathy Byrne. Thank you all for being here this morning. We're going to begin with a little bit of music, so I'll let you take it away. Thank you. Jazz. First thing Monday morning, courtesy of the Sturgeon Heights Collegiate Jazz Combo, under the direction of Kathy Byrne. Good morning. Thanks all for being here. Welcome to the studio, Kathy.
Thanks for having us here.
Well, first things first, I'm wondering, could you introduce the players who've joined us?
You bet. On bass guitar, we have Jack McDonald. On kit, we have Miguel Nobray. On trumpet, we have Jeremy Rogers. On trumpet as well, we have Ash Hebert. On trombone, we have Talia Hanford. And on vibes, we have Will Spensler.
Well, I'm very excited about this.
And oh my goodness, I almost forgot. We're kind of in a really tight space here, and it's almost impossible to see everyone because we're so tightly packed. On piano, we have Lorenzo Scalas, and he's actually an exchange student from Italy.
All right. Well, welcome all. And yes, Lorenzo is packed in the corner there. So you've really squished in. I have to say, this is very exciting because not only have you brought a seven-piece combo into the studio for the very first time, I was saying this before we went to air, this is the first time we've ever had vibes in the studio in addition to the kit. So this is a very exciting thing indeed. This, I imagine, only one of a few ensembles at Sturgeon Heights. Can you tell us a little bit about the band program, Kathy?
Sure. Yeah. We have a grade 9 concert band, a grade 10 concert band, a grade 11 and 12 concert band, and we have grade 9 jazz band, grade 10 jazz band, grade 11 and 12 jazz band. And then the combo is just kind of an extracurricular thing. So we've got a junior combo and a senior combo, and this is our senior.
And so the senior combo is, I would imagine, grade 12, some grade 11s in there as well?
Yeah, and we actually have one grade 10. Miguel is in grade 10.
Oh, no way. Well, yeah, what a great group of players indeed. Earlier, back in December, a few months ago, we had In the Heights here in studio, and I recognize one of the singers who was here as well, which was just a fantastic performance under the direction of Avonlea Armstrong Green. There's something going on music-wise at Sturgeon Heights, isn't there? There's quite the scene.
Well, we really like, we kind of feel like we're a family, and It's something that when the students are in the program, I think they feel a sense of community and a sense of family, and they love to make music together.
So. Yeah, and what a beautiful thing that is indeed, and you're doing a great job at it. Now, so you're here ahead of the family of festivals, the Manitoba Band Association Concert Band and Jazz Band Festivals that are coming up to close out this month. How many of your groups are you going to be taking there, Kathy?
Well, we're actually only taking one group, our concert band in grade 11 and 12. But we've done in previous years, we've done different groups depending on kind of other things that we're doing in addition to festivals. So, yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot going on, right? In terms of, you know, attending the concert band festival, why is it important to take students? I mean, this year, like you say, it's the concert band going. But, you know, this is something that you've participated in for a number of years. Why is it important to make your way down there?
So it's a great experience to be able to prepare music and have qualified people give you feedback. And so both the students learn from that and I as a director learn from that as well. And it's also a great opportunity for the students to hear other ensembles from different schools and just kind of see what's going on around the province as well.
Just out of curiosity, just kind of by a wave of a hand or something for the rest of you. I was going to get one of you to come over to the microphone, but I'm scared to make anyone move because something might fall over. We're so tightly packed in here. Have any of you played in the MBA festival before? Or no, not at all. I mean, yes, we've got the exchange student from Italy. No, has not yet participated. But have any of you participated in it before? Seeing some nodding going on. And I would imagine it was a good experience, exactly as you just heard, you know, Ms. Byrne saying. Yeah, we've got some thumbs up going on in the background as well. Yeah, it is one of those unique opportunities to hear others. I think that's a big part of it as well, right? You get to hear what other bands are doing and hear some tunes that you might want to play yourself in the future. Speaking of tunes, we're going to hear another because you're already in here. What are we going to hear? Oh, I forgot to ask. What did we hear to open this segment?
So that was Charlie Parker's Now's the Time and kind of our take on it. And this is Black Orpheus.
All right, we'll take it away. Live in the Classic 107 studio, this is the Sturgeon Heights seven-piece jazz combo, the Senior Jazz Ensemble.
Thank you.
live in the Classic 107 studio. We just heard Black Orpheus performed by a 7-piece senior jazz ensemble from Sturgeon Heights Collegiate under the direction of Kathy Byrne, who's hanging out here in the studio with us. Thank you all for being here this morning. Have a great day.